Well, before I started playing badminton, I used to play basketball, but I was terrible in basketball. But I like basketball at all. But and then I used to play volleyball. In volleyball, yes, I performed well, but my coach gone. And that was, I talking when I was in primary school, when I was a 10 year, and then I started in badminton. But the coach, no went every day. One day yes, two or three days no, and so. And then I left badminton. I go back volleyball too, and the volleyball coach gone again. And my school, because the school in Cuba is from 8 in the morning to 4:20 in evening. But if you get any school to practice, you go out of the school at 12 or at 1. So I get there at the sport to go out. So that sport was badminton, right? Yeah. I went to the court. The court was outside in the air. And they give me the racket. And then he realized I hit the shooter well. I said, okay, you come back tomorrow. I said, yeah, come back tomorrow. But I know when. I said, no, I don't like this sport. But I go back to the school. I spent 2-3 days in the school. But I realized I have to be there for 8 o'clock in the morning to 4:20. Say, no, I go back to badminton again. So I had to win. So I trained for 2 months. And then I went to the one small competition in Cuba. That is between province. I get there silver. I lose with one girl. She was in the sports school in Cuba, because Cuba have 3 sports schools. After that, I started to take my training serious, because I like most of the time look forward. I don't think just in live one day at a time. The selection in Cuba is once a month you have to go to the capital in Havana, because I born in Pinar del Rio. Right, you have to go to the capital, and they make a certain exam. I mean, jump, run, and some skill, and games. I never passed that exam. The only pass was the games in the court. So one day, the coach for the national team told me, no, Solange, if you want, you can leave badminton, because when we go to form the national team, we realize you have condition to be there, because you know can jump, you know run, you don't do nothing. I said, okay, fine. The next week follow was the other national, right? So I get there silver, and she told me, no, Solange, you get silver, you have to go back to the national team. And after that was the international tournament in Cuba. Caravan is the name. So I get there, team gold and bronze in single. The training in Cuba is hard, believe me, hard. Cuba training for 4 hours in the day, from Monday to Saturday. Sometimes from Monday to Sunday. In the morning, that is from 7:30 to 11:30, or from 8 in the morning to 12 in the morning, and then you go to get lunch, from 12 to 1 or from 12 to 2, and then you have 2 or 3 hours in the evening, depends in which part in the preparation you are. But the training in Cuba is really hard. Everything, gym, run, set up, push up, training in the court, specific training, physical training, technical training, nutrition training, or analyze video, all that kind of thing. To my sperm is up in your brain, and the baby will last be saying, come on, rhythm shall make your head jerk. Well, my life in Cuba was hard, because I was poor, very poor, black, and in my team everybody's white, everybody have money, and so how I born like so, I all time try fight to get my own thing, to be the best I can. So I did my career, I performed well in my sport, so now I want to pass my knowledge and my experience. Principal and my main reason to be the person who I am like right now is because I want to help the people who have the hard life, I mean.
dance, y'all. Have a ball, y'all. Throw your hands up. Coming with rhythms to make your head jerk.
My song is my life, my inspiration. After I get my child, after that, I won my first goal in badminton. Before that, I was a terrible player. Seriously, my son bring me luck in my life. Main reason me here is for help in badminton development and in the sport development in general. But my I am specialist, right, in badminton. So I did my career in Cuba for 6 years in physical education to teach and coach badminton, level 3. So here I saw all the conditions. But what happened? Somebody have to put the thing in place. For example, in badminton, the boy here have level. With good training, I'm sure they can get the second place in the next CSE. They can reach almost quarter to final in the Pan Am game, and at least one can qualify to go to the Olympic game. But right now, the Olympic game is right there. The national team don't start training yet. The Carabaco is right there. It's in August. It's in Barbados. Where is the national team for badminton? Right? So you never can get nothing if you don't sacrifice yourself. When I used to play here in Trinidad, and all the women saw me, all of them want to play like me, right? But when I started in badminton, I started just like them, but I spent year training under the rain, under the bad heaven, end of the Christmas training, end of the year training, all of that, and Cuba no give me no. And in Cuba, if you want to get something in the life, if you want to be good in the life, you have to sacrifice year. Trinidad, no? In Trinidad, you get all easy.
I took your
easy, yeah. That is the reality here. So you no can expect your federation to be good if you don't do nothing.
Ain't nothing wrong with staring at you. Girl, don't get scared of the fact that I envision.
To be honest with you, I know it's different system between this system and Cuba system, right? But what have we, the Cuban player, be strong? Because our system is so hard. So to get something in the life, you have to fight to get them. Here in Trinidad, I went to the Chinese tournament. Well, the Chinese tournament was... In my opinion, no was good. Why no was good? Because no was official in the line working. The official was the own player, right? No was a good referee with the high seat and thing, right? In the premiership, no podium, no nothing. In the youth festival, that was about 2 weeks ago, the same thing. In the other badminton open, I played the last one. I get triple crown, right? The same thing. The fan on. In badminton, you know, the intellect have to be close all time, right? And you know, can be the fan on because that's called a breeze and thing. So, if I ask about that, why here is like so? No, this is a small thing. I say, no, it's a small thing. Because if you don't care about your business, nobody comes to care about your business. How do you expect the player going to feel comfortable with that? To be honest with you, when I used to play for Cuba, right, I played with the people here around 3 or 4 times in my life. When in my journal, tomorrow you have to play with Trinidad and Tobago. I no rest, I no go to rest. That night I go to sleep at 12, 11 with my belly full. My belly full, eating meat. I go to the game room. And so because I don't care, because Trinidad is so easy. That is the truth. It's happening. That is the truth. Right? If I have to play with Peru, US, Canada. No. 6:30 o'clock in the evening, go to sleep. Right? You eat pasta. Right? Italian food. Don't try to get so much full. Right? And tomorrow, you're going to be ready. to that, like, but definitely I thought about that easy. That ain't nothing. You understand? I did my career, 6 years, in the university in Cuba. So I have my degree in physical education. But I do my thesis about badminton. Right? Injury in the ankle injury. But when I was in the national team for 5 years, I know be only the athlete. I was player and coach at the same time, because our coaches was preparing me and one male coach to supply them in the future. So sometime the female coach, she gone with a senior, with the junior team to Peru, and then and she give me the team for me to train. So all the medal Cuba achieved, so I work in part in that. So I think some people born to live that life. I born to play a sport, right? To do my best every time I am on the court. But outside the court, I like live my life, my simple life, right? I like my hair crazy, like so. I dress crazy too, so. And you lose all your private life. So it's something I want to go to the to eat in the restaurant. All the time you go to find somebody who going to interrupt you. Ah, you are so loud. Oh, give me a autograph or something. No. I don't like that so much. Sincerely, I don't like that so much. We, the athletes, sometimes when reach with certain level, higher level, they try or they feel like God. So they're not used to talk with people, you know, who have a lower level and things like that. I don't like that because in Cuba they say, you can't watch the sky and forget the land. You understand what I mean? So that is me. I have certain level now, but I started in zero in badminton. So I spent in badminton around 15 years. So I was growing step by step. And in all my life, I meet people with different kind of problems, in different kind of circumstances. So the life teach me to be like so. So that is me.